Jesus sent two disciples with these instructions. Go over to the village across from you. You will find a donkey tethered there, her colt with her. Untie her and bring them to me. If anyone asks what you're doing, say, the master needs them. He will send them to you. This is the full story of what was sketched earlier by the prophet. Tell Zion's daughter, look, your king is on his way, poised to be ready. Mounted on a donkey, on a colt, foal of a pack animal. The disciples went and did exactly what Jesus told them to do. They led the donkey and colt out, laid some of their clothes on them, and Jesus mounted. Nearly all the people in the crowd threw their garments down on the road, giving him a royal welcome. Others cut branches from the trees and waved them in the air. Crowds went ahead and crowds followed, all of them calling out, blessed is he who comes in God's name, Hosanna in the highest heaven. As he made his entrance into Jerusalem, the whole city was shaken. Unnerved, people were asking, what is going on here? Who is this? The parade crowd answered,
this is Jesus,
the one from Nazareth in Galilee. The word of the Lord.
Zechariah was a prophet a long time ago, and he would do things that Zechariah talked about, okay? And one of the things he did was to get on a colt or a foal or a donkey, depending on which version of the story you read, and he rode into Jerusalem as a king. It was not a horse. A horse was like this warlike image. So it was never a horse, but it was something like a horse, like a donkey. And he says, I'm going to do what Zechariah talked about to bring in God's kingdom. Okay? And the people who saw it, they said, hey, wait a minute, he's doing that Zechariah thing. I've read about that. I'm going to do, I'll do it too. And what they do is they throw their robes down or whatever, as like a, like we saw, sort of like a red carpet, if you will. And then they wave the branches. I've been up on the Mount of Olives, by the way. And it's very, very close to Jerusalem, and you can see down into the city of Jerusalem from the Mount of Olives. So he's going down, and they praise him as their king. Okay? A couple things. One, Jesus is doing a very dangerous thing because Jerusalem was run by a foreign empire called the Romans. Okay? So you don't crown anyone, you don't crown yourself king there because the emperor is already the king. Okay? And then secondly, the people who said, hey, Hosanna in the highest, this is, they're saying, this is our king. They're saying, not the emperor, but this guy. Okay? So they're doing this really interesting spiritual, religious, but political thing. Now, every day, we have an opportunity to crown Jesus as our king. You know that? Everything we do is an opportunity to kind of throw our stuff down and praise Jesus. Okay? So if we decide to use our gifts to hurt other people or go over and against other people and keep them down, then we're not crowning Jesus as our king. But if we use our gifts, the things, the talents that we have, if we use them to help others, to help the flourishing of other people, then we crown Jesus, just like they did back then. Okay? Now, the interesting thing about our king is that some things are going to happen to that king. Does anybody know what the special religious holiday is this Friday? It's May. Not right before Easter. Yes, ma'am.
Good Friday.
Good Friday, yes. And then, after that, we have Easter, okay? And I know you guys have a little break, and that's good, you can celebrate. Go to church. I just have to say that I get paid to go to church. All right, remember that our actions, what our gifts and talents, the things that God has given us, we can use those to crown Jesus King, okay? By helping our friends, by helping strangers, by being friends to everyone. Okay? Can I get an amen? Love and serve the Lord.